Let us turn to God now with our opening hymn and prepare ourselves for worship.
Thank you. No.
Is that Pedro?
No.
Thank you.
Have a ship without a navigator if you have no idea where you're going. is starving and is weak and is tired and needs real physical nourishment to sustain him on his journey. It may sound like it's just the average food that we get, but keep in mind, this was kind of weird. It was prepared by an angel while he slept. What would happen to you if you were hungry and said, "Oh, I'll take a nap now," and I'll wake up and suddenly there were some cakes and some water in your head, right? And someone said, "Eat." Who does that sound like to you? When we think about children and we think about ourselves receiving everything from God, it seems to remind us that a parent is the one that feeds us most often. For someone like myself that goes around town and eats at very different places, I'm not necessarily feeding myself. I have other hands that feed me. And when I come home and I cook for myself, I could say, easily, that, "Oh, I'm cooking for myself." But in some ways, would that deny all the hands and the plants and the water, the things that God created and gathered so that I may eat, if I say that I eat alone? In our world, it seems like we may be isolated. We may feel isolated and think that what we do for ourselves, what we feed with ourselves, what we do to feed other people is just something that we ourselves do. But it is so easy to forget then that we are part of a crew on a boat that goes on the river of life. In the passage today, Jesus is speaking, of course, not about necessarily real food. He's not talking about sustenance and the manna in the wilderness. He again is talking about himself for our life and for the life of the world. Jesus is talking about a kind of food that we get that nourishes and fills. We know this, don't we? We've felt it in our own lives. We know when we've been rejuvenated. We know when we have been filled. And we know that when we have peace and comfort in our lives. When we know that where we are going, even, is a sense of being filled. So why do we hunger so much? And why do we hunger for so many different things? When we think about a church and what it takes to fill it, we can talk about the people filling the pews, right? There are many ways to be filled. We can talk about ways in which the Spirit fills this place. And yes, that too can be one way we speak of it. But how we are fed in this place is through God's Word and through that trust and that faith and that gift. Not disconnected, but fully connected to the entire world through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. What life do we have together, though, in Christ? It seems to me that if we go through this passage, we can easily think that the last day is when we will receive this eternal life. But my friends in Christ, already been given this life. You've already received it in your baptism, and every time you come here is not just a reminder, but a point to feed your soul. When we listen to God's Word, it feeds us and prepares us to be crew members on this ship together. The eternal life that we have is one begun today, not tomorrow. If we wait until tomorrow to see that life, we may not appreciate the meal that is before us, the things that are sent to chew on a little bit in this world, the things that are meant for us to digest and take in easily. And the best way that we can come together around this is that we have these tools of the sacraments, of the Word, of this place. Please rise for our hymn.
Thank you.
Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Share a sign of peace with one another this morning. As we're concluding some peace, we are just a couple of announcements this morning. The Neighborhood Navigation Center is coming up on the 26th, and I will be outside with some sign-up sheets for those who want to participate in the meal share. And those who helped last time, thank you. I hope you had a good time. We'll continue to do that going forward. Also, just a special reminder that this month our outreach training is going toward movement disaster response in light of all the flooding and the fire going on in the world. And of course, as you know, please write it on an envelope and put it in just to remind Please rise and join me. Gathered together by the Holy Spirit, we pray as our Lord taught us in whatever language is closest to our hearts. Our Father,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
So as we celebrate our Holy Communion, our reminder that you can come forward with your mask on and lower them to receive the elements. You are invited to only take one element if that is what you choose. And we also have a gluten-free option if you need a gluten-free. Christ has set the table with more than enough. Come.
Thank you.
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen